everybody, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today we're going to give you a garlic update. Last fall, some of you may remember, we planted little bulbs of garlic and hoped that they would last over the winter. Well, yes, they have. They are doing really well. They're probably almost 3 feet tall. These are the hardneck garlic that work well in our climate. Over the winter, they start growing in the roots, and by June, as it is now on this hot steamy day, they have grown and they are now developing what's called scapes. This would eventually turn into a flower. Well, we don't want them to flower. We want them to put all their energy back into their roots so that we can enjoy the garlic when we're ready to enjoy it. So all you have to do is cut those out. Now you may say, well, what am I going to do with these? Just toss them in the compost? No, indeed. These are full power garlic, and there are many things you can make with it. Oh, the aroma is great. Here, do you want to smell?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, it's very potent. And I found a recipe for garlic pesto that I'm thinking I may try. So I will have to go to each one of these and cut them out.
Well, this is your small test bed, because over farther down is where you put all the main ones. These were some of the leftovers that you had.
Yes, they were. So if you let them go, they get long and they get curly, and then eventually they get their flowers on. But my authority on garlic said cut them as soon as you see them forming, because more energy then gets to go down to the actual bulb that we're trying to grow.
Well, I think I'll insert a little video section of you planting them last fall, and then we'll come back to this video.
When it was much cooler. So I got 11
cloves
of garlic, so you can see where they are. They're going to go 3 to 4 inches deep. And they're going to, you saw how big they were around, so you know you're going to have to leave that much space between each one that you plant, because you want it to get that big. I'll leave that one together. That one seems to want to stay. Yeah, and they're fairly easy to find. All you have to keep looking for is something that's curly, and eventually
What would happen if you didn't cut these off? I know the energy. Okay, so they flower, and then what?
Well, then their life cycle would be over then. I mean, you would still get some garlic underground, but it wouldn't be as great. And then you could, I suppose, save the seeds. But it's faster to grow garlic from the cloves of garlic rather than garlic seeds. So I will just continue on looking for scapes. I love that name, scapes.
Maybe they're escaping.
I'm helping them escape. Smells yummy.
Okay, so what happens if you were to pull one up at this point in time before the scapes either developed a seed, or even after you haven't let them go to seed? I mean, what do they look like now as
my real question.
That's a good thought. I don't know. Although while I was doing my research on scapes, they were talking about green garlic. So I'm wondering if that's what this would be considered if you dug them up now. So let me get my trusty knife. And I think I'll take this one because it's pretty close there anyway. Or unless I should take this one. All right, so I'm just going to carefully dig in. It's down there deep.
So you just can't pull them up, huh?
I could, but then I think we'd lose whatever's under there.
Well, I definitely can smell the garlic over here. And that could be coming just from your little tray here.
It's yes, amazing. It
could. I mean, I don't get that same smell when I'm in the grocery store.
No, well, oftentimes in the grocery store, we're eating elephant garlic, which really isn't a garlic at all. It's in the more in the onion family. So this is how big it is. It looks like a large green onion. And you could still use this. You could use it in a salad, or you could, you know, put it in spaghetti or whatever.
So by cutting the scapes off now, this will continue to grow and eventually give you a big bulb?
Yes, it should be.
With multiple cloves?
Exactly. Yep. So then what we will do is we'll eat some, obviously. We'll save some, but we'll take some of the ones and divide them and plant those again for next year.
Oh, so they're renewable.
Self-sustaining,
okay.
Yes.
Now, how much longer do you have to let them grow? Because you planted these in fall.
Yes.
They're at this, I mean, considerably larger than that little clove you put in.
Right.
So how much
but
longer?
But remember how big those cloves
were. Yeah, I know.
They were like that big. So you let them grow until they get brown and they start falling over.
So when the actual foliage turns brown, then you know it's time for picking.
Correct. And I'm not sure exactly when that'll be because this is the first time we've grown it.
Oh, cool.
It's very cool. Glad
so
we tried it.
You're going to use that for supper tonight?
Sure.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Well, we wanted to give you an update on how one of our experiments has been progressing. This because we are an experimental and eclectic garden. So we have a larger patch of garlic, obviously, and a smaller patch, and they both seem to be doing well. The one was a little more shady than the other, but they seem to be progressing at the same rate of growth. And look forward to eating some of these wonderful. I mean, the aroma is just wonderful. I'm surprised you can't smell it right through right through the ethers of the internet. It is wonderful. We will be protected from vampires for a long time now.
Good.
Well, we hope you enjoyed this little update. And if you did and you'd like to support our garden vlog, please give us a thumbs up. If you're growing garlic and you have a great recipe you'd like to share, we'd love to hear about it. And if you'd like to join our garden family, please subscribe. Bye for now.
So this is just the beginning. You've got a lot more scapes to go.
I do.
We'll get busy. Quit lollygagging here.
Connect with us on YouTube.